Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. So today's topic or video is about sponge filter maintenance. So this is a very commonly used filter in the hobby. So we're going to be talking about the benefits of this. I'm going to be opening it up and showing what it's got inside it. And let's see how it goes. Hope you guys like the video. Yeah.
This is how, this is like the commonly available sponge filter. I think its size is, you get it even in smaller size. So yeah, you get sponge filters in different sizes. Like this is like a really big one for about 100 to 200 liters of an aquarium. This is a little smaller and this is like really small. I mean, of course this can be used for a discus tank. And this, I took it from one of my planter tanks. So yeah, this filter is like really important for basically your biological filtration. So generally all this beneficial bacteria kind of stuff builds inside this. So I will be dismantling it and showing you how it actually works. So this whole thing actually can be opened out completely. This is one portion. This is the main sponge, which is kind of hollow. This is like the main stem, and through this hole is where the air passes through this, and you get that bubbling effect. So that's how the air passes through this and you have that suction. So this is like the main stem of the filter, and this is the base, which is kind of heavy, and the whole thing sits on this. So basically four, even this can be opened out like this. So you can actually keep adding and make a long one if you have two of them together. Like these pieces are all standard size. So even in the small one, you want to make like a really tall sponge filter, you can just add one more of this. It's all like standard stuff. So you can like add it in, add one more and make a really tall sponge filter if you have like a very big tank. So you need not spend too much money on, so you can add like this plus one more will come up, and you know, you can keep making a big one. So I took this one's piece, so I can add that also into this. So it's like I said, it's a common thing. So you can add even this into this. And connect this to the base, and you can really like make a tall sponge filter if you need. So yeah, so now the sponge filter generally comes in these four pieces. Now we get into cleaning one of these. There will be this filter. It's like I've just to take the video, I've not cleaned it in over 2 weeks now. It's like pretty dirty. Got a lot of junk. So let's take that out and give it a nice rinse. And these guys always like to come in front of the camera. Now let's remove the filter. It's just a plate, so we don't drop water all over the place. Let's see how dirty it is. These are some of the dirty things that we need to do in the hobby. Yeah, So this is again tank water, water from the same tank that I'll be using to clean this. Never use clean water or other water, because there is a lot of beneficial bacteria which is really stuck onto this, and which of course will be cleaning, but a lot of it needs to still remain. So never use clean water to clean your sponge filters. So there will be a lot of junk actually stuck in this portion generally. So if you're feeling like beef heart, mutton heart, heart mix, there will be a lot of it. It will generally get all stuck in this corner portion. You need to dip it, squeeze it and let it be, so you can actually feel the sponge kind of breathe inside the water. That's when most of your junk comes out. So I generally do like diagonal and also kind of horizontal. See, quite a lot of it is done. Maybe one more round of cleaning and that should be good. Let's do like one more round. Push the thing, squeeze it and let the sponge breathe. That's all you need to do. Squeeze it out in this direction and in this direction. This is pretty much it. No sponge filter needs to be like really clean. Will definitely have some junk, and that's how a sponge filter is kind of cycle. So this is really good enough. You need to look at it just after 15 to 20 days. This is going back into the tank. That's a clean sponge filter finally. It's a little bit more of water to clear up. That will clear up soon. So don't need to look at this for next 15-20 days.
So guys, thanks for watching our video. If you did, please do like and share it. And also do subscribe to our channel and support us to encourage us to make more videos. Thanks to you guys, we've touched 300 plus subscribers. This would not be possible without you guys. So keep it tuned up. Happy fish keeping. Cheers. Thanks.